As part of our MTE video series, we're going to cover the new Jacobsen TrueSet cutting unit. It's primarily the same cutting unit that Jacobsen has been using for the last 50 years that I'm aware of, but there is a new twist to it. They've done some modifications and they made it so that you can actually use this adjuster to adjust your reel to bed knife with a one click motion. I have disassembled one side of the TrueSet just to show you the components of the TrueSet cutting unit. So at this point, we're going to go through and reassemble the cutting unit. This is a trunnion, which is this ends up going inside of the reel tube of the reel.
So at this point, we're going to reinstall our trunnion and primarily set up our adjuster for our reel to bed knife. So the first thing you're going to install is the trunnion. Secondly, this is your adjusting screw. We'll run it down through the trunnion. I try to notate where the length of the adjuster before I tear it apart, so that when I put it back together, we're kind of close to where we started. So as you can see from viewing the other end, we're about in the same position. Now you would install this. This is a saddle. This will, it keeps the adjuster so that it isn't allowed to pivot. The trunnion itself has a hole drilled and tapped into it to accommodate the screw. So we'll run the screw down loosely to start with. The next step in the process is going to be to install the tension spring, which keeps tension again between the bed knife and the adjustment. At this point, we're going to reinstall this flat washer. We'll reinstall the flat washer. And our locking nut. Now we'll grab our tape measure. As you can see, we're right on the 1 3/8 inch mark. What you want your dimension to go from the flat of this saddle to the flat part of that flat washer, to the first part of the flat washer. And we were at 1 3/8. This is the clicker for your adjustment. This is what makes it so that you can actually are adjusting your reel to bed knife in 1/1000 increments. These little knurls fit on these stainless steel tabs on the bed knife backing. There's a groove in there, and as you're turning this, it clicks in here after the backing is installed. This is sensitive as to the position that it goes in. It's built on a taper. To save yourself some aggravation as you're reinstalling this, what I always do is put a little glob of grease on here. It acts kind of like glue to hold the clicker in place. When you reinstall your backing, it won't fall back out on you. At this point, we're going to reinstall our bed knife backing. Take your bed knife backing. I'm looking down inside of there to make sure that the adjusters are going inside of the slots on the bed knife backing. At this point, usually you can get it to tap in just by using either the palm of your hand or a hammer. We just cleared, when everything went down in, we cleared the clicker. It pushed the stainless steel piece out of the side that's attached to the bed knife backing, and we've now cleared everything. So now we can put our bed knife backing lugs back in. It's recommended that you put a small glob of grease on the lug, so that the lug itself will slide in the taper part of the reel frame. If you look over here, you'll see
that the frame has a taper built into it. And of course, you have to repeat the process for the opposite side. The bed knife backing lugs need to be torqued to 25 foot-pounds. We're gonna have to reinstall this saddle, which fits in the notch on the bottom of the bed knife backing. The saddle should be seated fully into the notch of the backing, and it goes up inside. There's two washers that come into play next. This is a spring-loaded washer that has a concave. The concave part of the washer should face the second flat washer, which is just a regular flat washer that'll be installed next. And then your castle nut. Run the nut down until it's tight. At this point, we're tight. Now you gotta find, there's a hole in the adjuster. Now back your nut off until the hole in the castle nut lines up with the hole in the adjuster. The older units had a cotter pin. The newer units are gonna have a hairpin in them. Just install the hairpin. Tighten up the screw that goes through the saddle into the trunnion. And at this point, we're ready to adjust our reel to bed knife. I'm using the board to support the cutting head. The way you adjust this unit in particular is a 7-blade Jacobsen cutting unit that will fit an LF550 or an LF510. And the recommended specification for reel to bed knife clearance is 2/1000. Here I have a 2/1000 feeler gauge. So we'll start our initial adjustment. You should normally start on the trailing edge of the reel. The reels are built on a twist on the helix. This would be your leading edge. This is your trailing edge. Start with your trailing edge of your reel when you adjust your reel to bed knife. What we're looking for is a drag between the reel and the bed knife. And we're about there for 2/1000 air gap on this end. We have our 2/1000 gap on this end, but the reel will actually act like a cam. And sometimes your adjustment will change on the opposite end when you adjust the first end. There's a nut, a bolt on this end that's in there so that you can turn the reel without putting your hands in there. Normally what I will do is double over the piece of paper. If it'll cut two of these thin pieces of paper, it's gonna cut grass. Ready to mow grass. Thanks for watching. This is how you set up the new Jacobsen TrueSet cutting unit. And please be sure to check back for more tutorial videos from MTE. Thanks.